Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on setting up data integrations in Financial Consolidation and Closed Cloud. Data integration enables you to integrate data from an external source system with Financial Consolidation and Closed Cloud. Data from your source system is exported to flat files or Excel files. You use data integration to map the data in the flat files to your Financial Consolidation and Closed dimension structure, and to import the data to your Financial Consolidation and Closed application. To set up a data integration, from the home page, open Navigator. In the Data Integration section, click Data Management. Select the Setup tab. The Source System option shows the available data sources. Data integration supports file-based data sources. Additional data sources will be supported in future releases. The target application for data integration is FCCS. The settings for the Financial Consolidation and Closed Dimensions are automatically configured during application creation. No setup is required. You create import formats to define the layout of source data files. You specify how to map columns or fields in your data source to your Financial Consolidation and Closed Cloud data structure. I'll create a format for loading this trial balance report file. Set the source type to ERP. For source, select File. For target, select FCCS. My source file is a fixed-length file, and the fields I want to import from it are numeric, so for file type, I'll select Fixed Numeric Data. Verify and save your entries. Now I'll map the fields on my load file to dimensions in Financial Consolidation and Closed Cloud. You can enter mappings manually or use Import Format Builder. The data file is opened in Import Format Builder. You can highlight a data field to map it to a target dimension. I'll map the account field in column 2 to my Financial Consolidation and Closed Cloud account dimension. To map dimensions that are not included in the load file, enter a start value of 1 and a length of 1, and then use the expression field to specify a member for the dimension. Import formats must include a currency row, so I'll use the Add menu to add one. I'll use the expression field to assign entity currency for the currency member. The rest of my mappings are displayed. Note that columns for the category, period, and consolidation dimensions are not included in the format. You select the period and category for which to load data when you run the data integration. All data integrations are automatically loaded to the entity input member of the consolidation dimension, so this dimension does not need to be mapped. After defining import formats, you create locations. I'll create a location named USAGL. You select a default import format to use for the location. When you create data load mappings and data load rules, you'll define member mappings and select a load file for each location. Let's talk about period mappings. Period mappings are used to map source system period names and keys to Financial Consolidation and Closed periods and years. The source system period key is typically the last day of the period. Default mappings are configured for you during application creation, based on your application calendar. You can modify the mappings as needed. Category mappings map source system data categories to Financial Consolidation and Closed data categories and frequencies. When you run a data load, you select the source system category for the load file data, and it is loaded to the Financial Consolidation and Closed category and frequency specified by the category mapping. Next, on the Workflow tab, you create data load mappings for each location. Data load mappings map source system member names for each dimension to their corresponding Financial Consolidation and Closed member names. Mappings can be anything from simple string replacements to powerful transformation logic. For example, I'll use an explicit mapping to map a single source entity to a single target entity. If you want to consolidate accounts, you can use a like mapping with wildcards to map multiple source accounts to a single target account. I'll map all accounts that begin with the prefix 11 in the source system to the cache account in Financial Consolidation and Closed Cloud. Now I'm ready to create a data load rule for the USAGL location. The data load rule specifies a data file to load into a selected category and period. If the file information is left blank, the user will be prompted to select the file at runtime. First, select a location, category, and period. I'll select July for the period. Enter a data load rule name and an optional description. Select an import format, and then select the file that you want to import. Click Save. I'll run the data load rule to test my setup. Verify that the correct period and category are selected in the POV before running the rule. I'll select Import from Source to import the data to the data integration staging tables so that I can verify that my settings and member mappings are correct before loading to Financial Consolidation and Closed Cloud. I'll leave Export to Target unselected. The Export to Target option pushes the data from the staging tables to the Financial Consolidation and Closed application. The status column displays the current state of the import process. Click refresh until you see a checkmark. A checkmark means the import completed without error. I'll navigate to the workbench to view the data in the staging tables. I can verify that the mapping of source members to target members is correct. Now I'll click export to push the data from the staging tables to Financial Consolidation and Closed Cloud. The data load completed successfully. I'll open my Financial Consolidation and Closed form to verify that the data was loaded. I can drill through from a cell in the data form to view the source data that was loaded into the cell. In this tutorial, you saw how to set up data integrations in Financial Consolidation and Closed Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.